there. I'm Diana Montford. What is this stuff right in front of me? Huh. Anyway, it's the lettering. It's the Diana Montford Show. I am she is I. I'm Diana Montford, the world's first transgender television journalist. Born male, became female. How do you like them apples? Anyway, my guest is transgender activist and certainly LGBT activist, Ms. Tanya Walker. You've seen her before. Hopefully you'll see her again. She's going to talk to us about all sorts of things. She does a lot of really nice stuff for the LGBT community, and she's going to tell us all about it. And if you live anywhere near the New York area, maybe you can avail yourself of some of her social services. Okay, so Ms. Tanya Walker. So now, tell us, what exactly are you doing right now?
Right now, I'm in a giving circle. It's called the Miss Major J2 Giving Circle.
Uh-huh.
It's Sylvia Rivera.
You keep talking. I
Project,
see something. I have to move.
And also Fierce. And we are in a giving circle currently raising money for Miss Major's retirement and J2's retirement.
Who is also, Miss Major's?
Miss Major is a Stonewall veteran and activist who lives in San Francisco currently.
Uh-huh.
And J2 is another activist who we're raising money for.
I'm going to drink my mulch smoothie here. I'm not advertising this stuff. I wouldn't give this to a dog, but it's good for you. You keep talking. I'm thirsty.
Yes. Yes, we currently raised over $22,000, and we are requesting a matching. We want to raise $40,000 for this giving circle. So
it will. Well, that won't last her whole life.
Yeah, because part of it will go towards J2 and Miss Major, and also to the three organizations who are constantly competing for funds.
Right.
Which is Sylvia Rivera Law Project, Audre Lorde Project, and Fierce.
Fierce, yes, I love all those organizations, but I think Fierce is really wonderful. It's about, you know, young people of color and having rights and not being chased out of Greenwich Village on the theory that Greenwich Village has now been gentrified and they do not wish to see young little gay folk who are obviously gay sitting on stoops and other things, you know?
Yes.
So anyway.
Yes, in the village currently.
How can people get hold of you to give you money they wish to?
They can basically Google the MMJT Giving Circle,
uh-huh,
and they can find us on there, our Miss Major J2 Giving Circle. And, you know, currently I was at Bernard College last Saturday with other members of the Giving Circle. And we were there talking about the Giving Circle. We're at a women's conference.
Uh-huh.
And we were talking about the Giving Circle and how we're raising money.
Every type of woman, cisgender, transgender?
It was mainly cis women there. But
I
was
nice
one of the only trans that I knew of. There could have been others.
Were they nice to you?
They were very nice to me. They clapped when I finished talking.
Did they know you were trans?
They knew I was trans.
Okay.
And so we're still raising money. We have like a hiking tour. We have we had wine and dine.
And we're making
a quilt.
What is this? This
a quilting
is muscle
circle.
Milk. It's vile. What is their, what I'm drinking. What is their, but it's full of vitamins. And also I'm thirsty and I'm coughing. But anyway, what is the point of this money? What will this money do?
This money will help the social justice organizations continue organizing and doing work in the community for LGBTQ, STGNC, SGL
people. What
is
STGNC? Sounds like a vitamin shop.
It's so many. I can't even think of it right now. But
yeah,
it's,
whatever. I mean, can't we just
it's
be two-spirit. LGBT?
It's two-spirit.
Questioning.
It's a lot.
Yes.
I can't think of it right
Wears
now.
Wears his mother's dress once a year. Any number of
things. It's a lot.
Yeah.
GNC is gender nonconforming. LGBTQ is lesbian, gay, bisexual, trans, and queer. T is there's intersex. There's same gender loving now. There's and people of color.
Well, same gender loving, isn't that gay?
Those are gay people. Same gender loving.
Oh, but no.
But they don't consider themselves gay. They consider themselves same gender loving.
Okay.
They don't want to be called gay. Or queer.
Okay. Well, that makes sense.
Anything
okay,
like that.
Sure.
They identify as that.
Sexuality is fluid. You can love someone of your own gender and someone of another gender, and yeah, that's fine. Now, where are these meetings being held?
Well, one time, we had to meet in someone's apartment because we didn't have a space.
Right.
We meet at ALP, Audre Lorde, or Sylvia Rivera Law Project on 24th Street, or either we meet at Australia, which is a lesbian organization.
Uh-huh.
We meet there for meetings. So.
And do people contribute at all?
Yes, we've raised over $20,000 so far.
And you want 20 more.
And we want a matching fund of 20 more to complete raising, because we want to raise like $10,000 for Miss Major's retirement and also for J2's
that
retirement.
That will keep her for the rest of her life.
I know, but it will be something for her, and we'll continue to raise money,
right.
While she's alive.
Right. Does she have Social Security and all that?
She may, but she still needs money towards retirement.
Right.
She's
right.
Still struggling.
Yeah. So many people in today's world are struggling. Unemployment is rife. Social services are being cut to the bone. Not good. So everybody needs help these days.
Yes, because I saw somewhere where we have like 60,000 homeless people in New York City, and I know that many of them are LGBT
people. You were
people.
Telling me before we went on that a friend of yours was rendered homeless today, and you are going to let him spend the night because
yes.
He has nowhere to go.
Yes, I'm going to let him spend the night, and hopefully we'll be able to find help for him. He came home. He said there was a notice on the door stating that he was evicted. And I said, did you ever get a letter to go to court? Because they're supposed to take you to court.
You're
they're
right.
Not supposed to
sure.
just evict you like
yeah.
that. So I don't know, how they could just evict him.
And where is this?
And this is in Harlem. But this is in Washington Heights.
Do you
it
know
was
the
in
street?
Washington Heights. Not exactly. It's 180th Street up there. Somewhere.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, he should go to a city council member, whoever that might be in that neighborhood. Talk to him. Your city council member is there for that. Excuse me.
Okay.
That's why they were hired. That's why they were elected. If you get into housing trouble, go to your political people. They will help you because it's good for their careers,
I would suggest that he go to the Department of Homeless Services. But however, in New York City currently, there's a housing crunch due to Sandy. So areas.
And if the department.
That flood, you can't live in anymore. So.
Excuse me. If the Department of Homeless Services were that good, we wouldn't have 60,000. I have a cold. It's winter as we shoot this. There wouldn't be 60,000 homeless people in the street.
Yes. Yes, that's currently the situation in New York City. Housing is, it's a problem. I mean, rents are high, sky high. I mean, the real estate rate in New York City doesn't go down. It only goes up. Gold goes up and down, but real estate in New York City just continues to go up. So people are investing trillions and trillions of dollars into property in New York City. You see them around in the streets every day, all up in Harlem, taking pictures of buildings
yeah.
which are occupied by residents from the community who've been in the community for years and years and years. And
in Harlem, that could mean 80 or 90 years, generation after generation in the same apartment. Since, the Great Migration North in the 1920s, they get kicked out, the building is torn down. High-rises are built.
And people are homeless. People are literally homeless. And, you know, I disagree with that law that states that convicted felons cannot live in public housing or get Section 8.
Where are they going to live?
That's another reason why the shelters are full. They need to reverse that law so that people can have a place to live. It's not fair.
Not only that, but I have a friend who has multiple sclerosis. Her home health aide had a daughter. They had to live in a shelter for 1 year here in New York before they could get Section 8. And that was the law. And I don't know if it still is. They had to live in a shelter for at least a year. Shelters can be very dangerous. The people in shelters vary as to their mental stability. And anyone who's traumatized by being thrown out into the street and living in the street is not going to be a happy person. So, you know, I mean.
And trans people in New York City who are homeless are living in women's shelters. And in those women's shelters, they're being misgendered and being discriminated against.
But that's better than it used to be because they used to be in men's shelters. And that was really horrific, so I've been told.
So,
I mean, we used to demonstrate and do shows about how they were putting. There was a wonderful young woman named, I believe, Mariah Lopez, who at the age of 16 was placed in a male shelter, male reform school, for want of a better term. She sued, this was circa 2003, maybe 1993, it was a long time ago, a year ending in three. She sued, and she was allowed at least the right to wear the clothes appropriate to her gender of choice. And that made a big difference, you know?
Yes, and currently, I know trans women now who are currently living in the shelters here in New York City, and they're being told that they must, just follow the rules and everything and do what they're supposed to do until they can find an apartment. However, they're being attacked. They're being threatened by some of the residents there. And it's not a good living situation. And when they complain, no one hears.
Why do we not somehow manage to get an apartment building and make it into a transgender shelter?
Well, we do have Princess Janae's place currently that's forming with Javon Martin here in New York City, which will be a trans-led, trans-specific shelter for trans folk who need immediate housing, and they'll be able to stay there.
On election night 2002, I asked Gifford Miller, who had just been elected as Speaker of the City Council, Gifford, you know, the city owns so many buildings. Do you think that we, the trans people, might have a building to make into a shelter? He laughed in a nice way. He wasn't a bad person. He said, Diana, look, you know, do you know how many groups are ahead of the trans people begging for buildings? Yeah. So it's very difficult, and this was in 2002, it's very difficult to get a shelter building for trans people. And I've been trying for decades to do that, to get the city to sell us a building for a dollar, for whatever. We'll find the money. We will make a shelter for trans people. Nobody gives a damn. Nobody's willing to help.
And to, you know, to piggyback on what you just said, trans people are in need of housing in New York City. Everywhere. They're in need of safe spaces to hold a meeting.
Yeah.
We need safe spaces. We need housing. We need safe places to be educated. We need safe spaces for everything. And, you know, for life skills, for everything in our life. And currently, I am a facilitator for two groups with SAGE, working with senior citizens.
Senior Action in a Gay Environment, SAGE. It's the Gay Senior Citizen Organization.
Yes, I'm working with older, mature trans women, a women's group downtown on SAGE on 7th Avenue, 305 7th Avenue.
Yeah, on 13th Street.
Yes, and
at the Gay Center.
There's a difference
here in New York,
and also do a group up in Harlem, the SAGE group in Harlem, which is the transgender, which is the Harlem Transgender Empowerment Group, and I facilitate a group there.
Do people of color, including trans women, wind up homeless more often than Caucasian folk? Because I have never been homeless, but surely transgender women of color are, and that does that have something to do with their color?
Well, it could have something to do with their gender identity, their color, because people, like I said before, people always confuse gender identity with sexuality, and when a trans person is attacked, they usually yell homophobic epithets at them, like faggot, queer, you know, things like that. They never, call them names that they would call a woman, a whore, or this, or that.
Bitch,
you know, they call a bitch, they call a slut, they call her
a faggot. Yeah, that kind
get the hell out of here. Look at him, and they misgender the person.
Oh, look at that dress. Let's see what's under that dress.
And then they attack. You know, they attack you. So they don't, they feel like some people feel like they have the right to self-determine for us.
Why are
our gender?
So many transgender folk are emotionally fragile. Why is that?
Due to being assigned the wrong sex at birth. I think they should stop assigning sex at birth. And it could solve the problem.
But the world doesn't work that way, you know that.
They should stop. They should stop with this, with the gender.
But a lot of mainstream people want their children to be girls or boys, and we bought the blue layette for the boy, and you know, it is what it is, you know.
Yeah, it's creating a lot of problems because everyone. You know, they judge you by your genitals, and gender is not your genitals. Little girls grow up to become women. You know what I'm saying? Little boys grow up to become men.
Whatever their gender might be.
However, they've changed the sex on intersex people.
Right.
And when they had ambiguous genitalia or they had like a penis and a vagina, they would remove the penis and keep the vagina.
Or vice versa.
And the child would grow up to be a man.
Yes, but not always.
Instead of a boy.
Yes, but John Money did that. He, a boy's penis was burned off with circumcision or something. And John Money said, well, it's fine. We'll give him a vagina. He'll grow up a girl. He was an infant. Well, everyone thought, sure, why not? Turned out, even though this person born male had a vagina constructed in infancy, there was something in him that was man, that was boy, that was not woman. And even though he was given frilly pink dresses and little dolls and everything to play with, he'd say, no, I want the truck. I want to play hockey. I don't want to wear this. I want to wear the jeans, you know? So maybe, just maybe, just as we trans folks say, well, gender is, we are born with a sense of the gender we are, whether male or female. Maybe cisgender straight people are every bit as devoted to their gender as we are to ours, you know?
Which goes to the fact that I believe that gender is in your mind, which it is in your mind. Because, see, they saw the ambiguous genitalia and they assigned a sex to the child.
Right.
So, and the child's mind said that it was male after they constructed the vagina grew up. So that's proof. They do not understand the brain, the human brain and gender. And they do not understand in the critical stages of development of the brain in the womb, where the child is either gonna grow up to be male or female.
Right.
So they don't know. They could, but that they do feel like they have the right to assign you a sex at birth,
but
which
they assign you a
up.
Social security number. I mean, we live in that kind of world. People like categories, and they like, you know.
I just feel like they shouldn't do that because it screws people up. I mean,
people
when I was coming along, people who were trans were getting diagnosed as schizophrenic.
Yes, but
because
how
you're trans.
How many people are trans? Like, 2% of the world's population. So we really have no right to make rules for everyone else. I mean, let's face it, you know.
Right. And then, and that goes to say, you know, and getting off of that.
I have no problem with being assigned male at birth because I was so clearly not male. I'm more masculine now than I've ever been. That's what politics did for me. But anyway, it made me really tough and awful. But anyway, I used to be very sweet. But anyway, you know, it's fine if you can then transition to another gender. What I'm saying is so many trans people seem to be so emotionally fragile. And I don't understand that because to me, being trans shows how strong you are, you know? And maybe in my family, we idealize strength and all that. And in other families, you know, people like, oh, the poor dear, oh, so unhappy, you know, and all. But, I mean, you know, like, come on. Our parents went through world wars and depressions and I don't know what else. They couldn't wimp out. Why should we? And aren't okay. we lucky? We get to live out our dream of being trans.
Yes.
So, I mean, you know.
And, you know, the whole trans thing of being called transgender and things like that. Transgender is an umbrella term which encompasses a lot of different people.
And it's a hell
people.
Of a lot nicer than it used to be.
Yeah, but
people
still
say, oh, look, it's a transvestite.
So a friend of mine and I are thinking about, you know, thinking about how to unwind from all these names and labels that we were given.
I don't think that's possible. I really don't.
Because there's too many people under the umbrella that say they're trans. And they
so
also...
What? They
it's
have a
many,
right to
it's
if
too
they
many
want
people,
to.
But transgender women
oh, now,
and men.
Well, we can't turn around and be as fascistic as the cisgender world and say, well, you can't be transgender because you didn't spit through your fingers last Tuesday, or you can't be transgender because I don't like that hairstyle. No, no, no. If they say they're transgender. And we have no right to say, you can't say that.
Right, but you know it's a problem. Because a lot of trans women, and I could speak for women, are not getting hired because there's too many people under the umbrella. So where did transgender come from? What are you, and well, what is transition? What
no,
are you transitioning
but,
to?
But excuse
I've
me.
Always been a woman.
Yes, but
I didn't transition.
There was always the pink, I used to sell cosmetics for years. I did that during the 80s. There was, and I transitioned much earlier. Even if they knew, they didn't care. There's always been the what they call the pink collar ghetto, the you know fashion beauty world. They don't give a damn. Be a girl. Who cares? Do anything you want. Wear a dress. Fine. Just make sure you're here on time and sell a lot of makeup. That's all they cared about. So yes, if a transgender woman wants to be hired in another field, probably that would be a problem. But in beauty culture and fashion, it's never been a problem. I mean, go where you're wanted, you know? Of course, everyone should be hired for everything. But if you're not, go where you're wanted, you know?
Because, we want to get rid of the name, transitioning. What are you transitioning? Transitioning to me is moving from Florida to New York
right.
to a new job.
Yeah.
I'm not transitioning. What I'm doing is I'm living in my gender. I'm not transitioning to anything.
You know, a lot of trans people make me feel very insensitive because I'm a real toughie and I feel that something's wrong with me because everybody else is going, oh my God, oh, I'm too fragile to live. Oh, be nice to me. Oh. And I'm saying, you better fucking be nice to me or I'll rip your nuts off and shove them up your ass sideways. Needless to say, this makes me seem quite insensitive and crude. Maybe I am, and maybe that's a good thing. Maybe that's survival, you know? I mean, I don't know.
Yeah, but, you know, it's that transgender, and it's really an umbrella term, and it really pushes trans women out of a lot of things in their lives, and trans men. It does. People who see themselves as men and women are being, you know, are last to get hired, you know, and last to live, to be self-actualized in society. As in Abraham Maslow's pyramid. So we want to get rid of those names, transgender, trans
this,
trans
that. So what do you call people born
just men and women. We're not born another gender. We are assigned the wrong sex at birth.
Yes, but bit by bit and moment by moment, you cannot foist this on the cisgender world and demand instant, complete gender blindness from everyone.
Watch us.
Well, no, honey, I've been trans since before you were born, and I know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
And it is so much better now than it was
45
years ago. Damn, I'm old. I transitioned at 15 and started taking hormones at 19, if you're interested. Transitioned in 71, started taking hormones in 75. Because as puberty erupted, I was getting too readable. But anyway, so I popped those pills from a good doctor, Dr. Harry Benjamin, who invented the process. My point is this. We have progressed tremendously in a half century. I am a witness to this. You know this. we are still progressing quite well. But there are limits as to, I mean, gender is one of the foundations. Okay, you're wearing makeup, I'm wearing makeup. We're wearing, quote unquote, women's clothes. Clearly, we love gender because we're doing like high femme here. Well, okay, my hair isn't so femme, but you know what I mean. I mean, we're doing like total femme here. So we do have respect for gender norms because look at us. I mean, if we had no respect for gender norms, we would be wearing no makeup and totally gender neutral clothing and we wouldn't look like anything. We would be of no gender.
Yes, some people don't want to be in the gender binary.
Yeah.
They don't want to be he or she or they or them or anything. They don't want to, they're against the gender binary. And I mean, these people are very serious about that.
Well, good. Now let them try to convince the other 98% of the world's population that they should do it their way.
They just don't see gender. And
ultimately, to a point, we all have to conform and join society to a point if we're going to survive. You just said, well, trans people are often not hired. Well, let's...
Trans women.
All right. Cisgender women aren't going to be hired if they walk in a miniskirt and their tits hanging out and some frizzed out wig. I mean, you know, do the corporate thing and you'll get hired.
I mean, well, some trans women are doing the corporate thing and they're still not getting hired because they're trans. When you're trans, you know, when the trans men transition.
We have 1 minute.
Okay.
My guest has been Ms. Tanya Walker, transgender activist. I'm Diana Montford. This has been the Diana Montford Show. And you can contact Tanya Walker where?
Tanya Walker, LAD, 2014, at outlook.com.
Okay, and I'm Diana Montford, and I love you even if no one else loves you. I love you, and I don't care what you look like, and I don't care what gender you are. Fuck no. You're you, and I love you. See you next time. Mwah!
We go on.
Yeah.